though the first few times I was rejected, I came back around the way to let you know I was affected by the beautiful features of God's greatest created date. I begged you for a date in order you could say what's maybe. So I played your love games, but ain't the game your heart was set on. I had my head on, hoping you know you wasn't led on by no playing type. Time passed by when I lost patience, I said today I might. Been hoping that I could get a date tonight, and all because of my persistence. Constant existence, the focus in your office now no longer in the distance. Instantly got your advantage, managed to get your number. From then on we talked, never dated until the summer. Just before the 10th grade, made reservations at the classiest and most elegant dining establishment. You're most definite, I'd spark your interest, which was evident that I had, because I knew that you was glad when you walked in looking all mad. Had to look into my eyes, holding hands under the dark skies. No longer victim of lies, cause now your heart is all mine.
I love my shorty more than life.
About a year passed by, grade 11, almost commission. I've been spending all my time out of your side, representing faithfully. Gratefully blessed to be free from all the stresses of that X to the next. Mess had you loving nothing less, close to next semester. Had to jet out to rectify the situation. Asked you if you could follow on a vacation, but your moms wouldn't allow that. School is a first priority, and I wasn't about to go against higher authority. Gave a tisk about, promise I'd fight you every night. All the time that I was gone, I wish that I could hold you tight. One night, I got a call from your mom at 4 in the morning. She said something happened to get back home before too long. I'm by your bedside in a hospital room where you lay sleeping. Doctor said you was unconscious cause you got raped over the weekend. I saw your mom sweeping, gave over a hug and started creeping. Deep in the thought on how I could leave you alone so he can get his hands on you. Investigation's going down, I saw you open your eyes, and my voice was the only sound that you heard when you were woke. When I spoke, the sound was light by your ear, whispered I'm here and everything's gonna be alright.
I love my shorty more than life.
We graduated together another year later. I always stayed by your side, cause right beside you I feel safer after the accident. Feeling that I'm somewhat responsible, knowing that I was gone, keeping you close was impossible. One night we both went out for a walk at the park, in the dark started to talk about the feelings we thought. Then I got on my knees and pleaded that you accept if I propose. Pulled out the camera ring, watched a shot of eyeballs. I suppose it was the shock of the moment, I guess. Though your answer was yes, what happened next left us no time for happiness. As you collapsed into my arms, I cried out for assistance and an ambulance. And rush to emergency in an instant. I waited in the waiting room with your mom's in a panic, keeping my cool, wondering how the fuck could I stand it if I lost you after every trial and tribulation we faced. Looking to doctor's eyes, hoping that I could find a trace of positivity. Instantly, you felt my heart stop, but not long after I came to, I found out that you was gone. Lost the one thing in the world I would have died for, and no less stress. Finally, knowing the results of your AIDS test. Damn.